Hi everyone, I'm Rachel. In this tutorial, I'll teach you how to color a neon portrait using the Color Therapy app. This is a really fun and unconventional way of coloring a portrait. If you'd like to follow along, find this image under Fashion, Star Fashion. Okay, so I wanted to first start off by showing you this reference I'm gonna be working from. This is just to help inform me of where to put my highlights and shadows. Over in the exotic palette, I'm going to set it to gradient. And I'm using the 6th color on the top row, and I'm setting the gradient so pink is on the right side, and I'm just going to tap in the background. Now using the airbrush tool, set the size to 100 and opacity at 10. Over in the glow palette, I'm going to be using the 1st color on the 2nd row. And with coloring inside the lines mode set to off, I'm going to start to draw a large blue orb in just really soft layers. And this is going to be the reflection of the blue neon light against the wall that's going to in turn reflect on our subject. And then you also want to sample that darker blue on the left side and just bring it into that as well, just very softly towards the outer area of your orb. So just kind of separating those two colors a little bit with the darker blue. And then back in the glow palette, I'm using the 2nd color on the last row and doing the same thing just up in the top right corner, just making a really, really big circle, just drawing a nice orb of light reflecting on the wall. And I'm making it much more pink in the furthest corner. Now with that same darker blue that we had sampled, let's go ahead and tap to fill in our subject completely. And with the airbrush tool now, let's set the size at 60 and opacity at 40. Now let's turn coloring inside the lines mode to on, and I'm going to zoom in on the face a little bit. So I'm using that pink that we had before, and I'm going to just draw some really broad strokes across the face. Once you get up towards where the crown is, if you don't want to keep it, just turn coloring inside the lines mode to off, and then you're just going to add broad strokes into the forehead. And I'm focusing on the right side of the face, the top right side, because that's where the light is reflecting onto the face, the pink light. I'm also going to bring it down into the throat and neck softly, a little bit onto the shoulders, and maybe just a touch underneath the left eye, and then right below the nose too. I also am going to make my subject with her eyes closed, so I'm going to just draw them pink. Now let's switch back to that light blue, and now let's lower the size. I'll be using between 1 and size 25, so let's just start in the middle, size 15 or so, and the opacity at 20. So let's add our light blue highlights to the chin. So I'm following along the jawline and turning coloring inside the lines mode to on near the chin. Bring it down into the neck just a little bit, and then right underneath the nose, highlight that blue since our bright blue light is coming from below, and then the bottom part of each lip. And then I'd raise the size a little bit. Let's go to 25. And around the left eye, turn coloring inside the lines mode to off if you don't want to include the stars. I'm just drawing some blue over that eye. Just bringing that highlight underneath that eyebrow and just right above that cheekbone. Then just a little bit in the forehead area. And then also I'm just tracing the shoulder, the left shoulder, just a little bit. Now I want to give a little context to my eyes. So I'm going to lower my stroke opacity down. I'm just lowering it down to 0. And I'm going to draw in the eyelashes since I want to have her eyes shut. So I'm just doing size 1 and opacity 70 with the airbrush tool. I'm using black. And with coloring inside the lines mode too off, just trace along the lower lash line, and then you can add in your little eyelashes. And they don't need to be perfect really quite yet. This is just to help you kind of know where you're going to add your next highlights and shadows. So I'm going to do the same thing on the other eye, just following underneath that lash line on the bottom. And just now go over to the blue palette and select the 3rd color on the 2nd row. Let's set our opacity at 70, and I'm using size 20. Let's just draw a broad shadow just on the far left side of the nose. You can bring that up into that eyebrow. I'm going to shade the left eye a little bit. And now I'm bringing that down into the darker parts of the face. So if you need to turn coloring inside the lines mode, you can on. And now I also want to switch to black and start adding in our really darker shadows. So that's going to be on the hairline, essentially. I would lower your opacity down to 20% and bring a little bit into the corner of the neck and just a little into the hairline and into the hair as well. For the hair, I'm using the flat brush tool, size at 55 and opacity at 35. And I'm going to be using that same light blue as before with coloring inside the lines mode set to on or off, depending on if you want those little stars, and just draw in the hair. So you want to do like quick sweeping strokes going down the hair, starting at the top of the hairline. Then you can also use some black and bring that in there again from that hairline. Now back in the airbrush tool, let's set the opacity at 20 and the size down to 25. So we're going to continue to add in our shadows and highlights. So I'm just very softly adding in a dark shadow along the jawline, just above that blue highlight. You can kind of bring it up into the jaw a little bit, just with little soft strokes, as well as into the temples softly. Now you want to continue to work on your shadows, so you can lower all the way down to 1%, and you can draw in the nostrils. I'm just drawing in one, and make a really nice dark line just along the nose. Now switch back to our pink, and let's have the size at 20 and opacity at 35. Now let's add in our details. So just make some areas a lot brighter and more detailed now. So the areas that are gonna be the brightest will be on the areas that are closest to the light. And you can just make a little circle where the nose is. And then you can also use a smear tool to refine it. So size at 18, opacity 100. I'm just gonna blend the nose a little bit. Move around those colors, kind of just working back and forth with my reference. And now in the pink palette, choose the second color on the second row. Let's set the airbrush tool size to 15 and opacity at 50. So your brightest highlights are going to be on the right side. So I'm just adding a very soft glow to the right eyebrow and forehead and bringing it down just a little bit into the nose. And then on the right side of the nose too. Let's lower it now all the way down to size 1. And now you want to make the shape of the nose. And then use a smear tool to further refine your lines. Don't forget to use a reference because it will really push your drawing further. If you'd like to see more tutorials like this, don't forget to subscribe to the Color Therapy YouTube channel so you don't miss any new tutorial videos. Thanks for watching our tutorial. You can get the Color Therapy app for free on the App Store.